Was Davey, was there in fact a secret trapdoor designed to injure wrestlers that were no longer wanted? Did Davey Boy have drug and alcohol addictions, and if so, to which ones? Why exactly did he die at the young age of just 39? We'll explore relevant questions regarding his health, death, and autopsy, and we'll also explore the claims of homicide made by Davey Boy's heartbroken father, Sid Smith. Davey Boy Smith, the British Bulldog, was a unique, colorful, and charismatic wrestler, wrestling in both the old, later also becoming the WWF European Champion.
In May 2002, Davey Boy Smith went to sleep one night and apparently was found dead the next morning by his partner Andrea Hart, seemingly out of the blue. They were staying at a house of their friends, Monica Anderson. Andrea said at the time, "I noticed he wasn't breathing, he was just kind of blue," she said. "I called Monica right away, but it was too late."
She denied that Davey Boy Smith had been taking drugs before his death, apart from a muscle relaxant for his back. So what really happened? We'll try and piece together the answer to this, and with what limited information that we have. Did British Bulldog use steroids and growth hormone? It's Ultimate Warrior in 1992 because of this. Interestingly, WWE carried out a documentary on the circumstances of his death.
It was Fall Brawl 1998. They were going to have the Ultimate Warrior come up through the floor. They kept this sort of a secret to all the wrestlers that there was a metal door with a sort of like a doorknob handle. My father was not aware of this, and I think he took a back body drop and he took another bump onto it. Noticed towards the end, he went to pick up Disco Inferno from the running power slam, and he seemed to have great difficulty with that. And I remember him coming back home, and he was complaining of his back injury, and there was a bunch of other guys complaining about it. He ended up breaking his back. He was starting to get pretty heavily into the pain medication and the prescription pills and stuff like that. He got started on morphine. It was not really a gradual thing at all. It was all of a sudden, it was just boom. And I could see that this was turning into a serious problem.
He went into rehab, and he came out and then lost his mother. And then shortly after that, Owen died. Davey, no surprise to anyone, was on drugs and had been trying to go through rehab a few times, but never did get it figured out.
There was not the same spark anymore. A lot of the injuries were starting to really pick up.
And I knew, in my mind, I knew that with my body there was something wrong. And everyone around me thought, you know, this guy's got a drug problem. And I did have a drug problem. I couldn't get off the morphine. So I checked into a rehab in Grand Prairie. I stayed for 7 weeks to clean my system out. I was getting so much pain, I was crying. I could barely stand.
I was going through, if not a nervous breakdown, pretty close to it at the time.
My mom and dad were very good for both of us during that time, but I couldn't accept that Davey couldn't live with this pain. And I thought, well, my dad broke his back, my dad did this, my dad did that. How come you can't do that? It was just falling apart.
My mind was, she was in a huge state of depression. She had several times tried to get Davey to get his act together in order to get Davey to get himself together. Ended up even trying to take her own life, and it almost happened. She came very close to dying, and actually had to jumpstart her in an ambulance to get her to come back, and that was terrible.
Davey had so much pain, and then his emotional pain. He just lost his sister. He was pretty sick about that. He didn't need to be condemned because he was addicted to morphine.
The pain in his back was getting very, very extreme. He ended up doing x-rays, they did an MRI. He had a staph infection in his back.
A heart attack of some sort, just out of town. He was just sort of cleaning up the last bit of his business affairs.
It's interesting because in this documentary or excerpt by WWE, there is mention of an injury whilst Davey Boy was in WCW and seemingly a lapse in the health and safety department there. There is mention of subsequently becoming addicted to pain relief medications, including morphine, as a result, but there's literally no mention of steroid or growth hormone use. Here's a clip from Ultimate Warrior, however, where he mentions that the fall in WCW had nothing to do with Davey Boy's self-destructive behavior.
Were you aware that the wrestlers were going to the ring without knowing that there was a trapdoor there and they were getting hurt by taking bumps on it? Do you think the company should have been more responsible about telling the wrestlers?
I didn't know they knew. Yeah. Didn't know.
Yeah, that's how Davey Boy...
No, Davey Boy, man, Davey Boy was gone before he ever took a bump on that door. Go watch the tapes. He was all doped up and stuff. He was, you know, Neidhart told me on a plane one night that they were smoking crack and stuff. that they were into smoking crack, and something was wrong with Davey Boy. Yeah, I mean, he couldn't even walk right.
Okay.
Was the British Bulldog an alcoholic? There have been quite a few rumors of this, that the British Bulldog did have an alcohol issue, and if you look at this TV commercial, for example, he appears to be drunk even here.
Your challenge makes me laugh. What makes you think you can survive the bite of the British Bulldog and get it alive? You have yet to face a superior athlete like myself, so get ready to step in the ring and feel the wrath of the British Bulldog.
Shades of George Best and Terry Wogan. Now, there was a podcast with Bruce Pritchard where there was mention made apparently of a random heart attack out of the blue.
Let's talk about the end, man. This sucks. A week after he has that match with his son on May 11th, he passes away on May 18th. He suffers a heart attack.
Again, not true. There was no mention of heart attack, aka myocardial infarction, and seemingly a poor understanding of what this term means and confusing again with sudden cardiac arrest.
And an autopsy would reveal that anabolic steroids may have played a role in his death, but no reason was given.
Actually, this is wrong. There was information given, limited information, but enough to piece together what really happened, and we'll come on to that shortly, and why there was steroid use suspected by the coroner and medical team to have contributed to his death. Again, I don't want to sound arrogant, I just don't think that these guys understand how the findings of the autopsy can be linked to steroid use, so it's just easier to say heart attack can happen to anyone, right? Wrong. That's not what is going on with these wrestlers, and again, I'll explain why later on. So coming on to what information we have of the autopsy of Davey Boy Smith, the first thing I think is very important to point out is, unlike many of the states in America, the United Kingdom does not permit the public, and that includes doctors, access to autopsy reports for 75 years after the individual's death, unless a relative requests it. So unlike the Ultimate Warrior and Randy Savage, I do not have the full autopsy report, and so I'm working with limited information here. I will try and stick to factual comments made by the coroner as opposed to media speculation. That being said, I think there's still enough information to work out what happened. By the way, if by any chance a family member comes across this and you have Davey Boy's full autopsy report, I can, of course, with your consent, carry out a full analysis. So what information do we have? Most of the quotes from the medical personnel from his autopsy are from this article in the Manchester Evening News. Forensic scientist Julie Evans said she found levels of morphine and steroids in his body, but they were not high enough to kill him. The levels found suggest a history of therapeutic use of codeine and morphine, but there is no scientific evidence of abuse. There were high levels of testosterone, but many athletes can have a higher levels of testosterone than the average person. I'd have to disagree to a certain extent with our forensic scientists here, as testosterone levels start to decline from 30 years onwards, so to find very high levels of testosterone in a near 40-year-old is a little unusual, unless of course there is exogenous synthetic testosterone involved, i.e. anabolic steroids. Coroner Jennifer Leeming recorded a verdict of natural causes after pathologist John Rutherford said Mr. Smith suffered from cardiac arrhythmia. Natural, by the way, just means there was a disease process, as opposed to suicide or a car accident, for example. It doesn't mean that the death was inevitable. Arrhythmia means an abnormal electrical rhythm of the heart, which, as we've mentioned in other videos, is often a consequence of enlarged heart, which is often a consequence of steroid and growth hormone use. There is also another article in the Los Angeles Times which states that the preliminary cause of death was hypertrophy, an enlarged heart, with evidence of microscopic scar tissue, possibly from steroid abuse. So again, we're seeing a pattern here. Steroid use, enlarged heart, sudden cardiac arrest. Remember the Ultimate Warrior commenting on this, where in autopsies on wrestlers who have passed away which demonstrated enlarged hearts due to steroid abuse.
Approach. Wrestlers take the steroids so they can look healthy on the outside, but they do everything else that makes them rotten on the
Warrior,
inside.
Did you know
and the autopsies that reveal that they have enlarged hearts and other organs that have been affected by the steroids.
An enlarged heart. As mentioned, this can be a consequence of steroid use. The heart enlarges, there is subsequently scar tissue, and this enlarged heart puts a person at great risk of an arrhythmia or dysrhythmia, which means an abnormal electrical conduction and sudden cardiac arrest, which is what I believe happened. Remember, there is continual electrical activity in your heart from the moment you are born until the moment you die. Any disruption in this electrical activity which having an enlarged heart puts you at risk of, can result in sudden cardiac arrest, i.e. death. So what we are seeing here is a clear pattern. Remember, a man's heart should not weigh more than 450 grams. Randy Savage's heart was significantly enlarged at 610 grams. States here, cardiomegaly, which basically means enlarged heart. Cardia, the Greek word for heart, mega, also from Greek meaning extremely huge. Ultimate Warrior's heart was even larger at 650 grams. And we have mentioned here in British Bulldog's autopsy that his heart was enlarged. So in the words of Bruce Hart, former trainer and brother-in-law of Davey Boy Smith, Davey paid the price with steroid cocktails and human growth hormones. Again, to be very clear, a heart attack, the medical name for which is myocardial infarction, is when there is complete occlusion of one or more of the coronary arteries. That is one of the blood vessels that supply the heart muscle. And there is no mention of this on any of these autopsy reports. By the way, many people who are having a heart attack are actually awake and conscious. Approximately 70% of heart attack victims survive. This is different to what we're seeing here with these wrestlers, which is a cardiac arrest, heart completely stopping as a result of misfiring heart due to the enlargement and scar tissue, almost certainly as a consequence of steroid and other illicit substance abuse, as actually specifically pointed out by the medical team here in the case of Davey Boy Smith. Coming back to the assertion by Sid Smith, Davey Boy's father, who is still alive today, by the way, he commented in 2004, "I believe my son was murdered. He was so fit and healthy. It doesn't make sense. He was about to make a comeback. I'm so shocked. I don't know what to do, but I might go to Canada to try and find out more. We are all devastated. He will never be forgotten." I don't know if there is any evidence of homicide or what came of his search for more information in Canada. And if anyone has any more information, like I said, I'm more than happy to give my take on it. But I mean, this is sad. I think if he took into account the substances his son was taking, there would be a better understanding of what happened. But it is heartbreaking nonetheless. I mean, Warrior and Randy Savage were survived by their mothers, even though they passed away in the mid-50s. But Davey Boy here was only 39 and by all accounts a lovable family guy. Unfortunately, this is the toll that the wrestling industry and environment is fostering, and unless there's a change in culture, we'll be seeing more and more painful and premature deaths. The entertainment for the fans will go on, the money will keep rolling in for the wrestling industry. Is it really worth the lives of so many young wrestlers? What about the vacuum and pain it leaves for decades on end to their families? As with anything else in life, to bring about change, the first step is to identify and clearly highlight what the problem is, and that is what I'm trying to do here. Anyway, if you're finding any of this useful or interesting, hit the like, subscribe and notifications button for more breaking analysis coming up on this channel. Until next time, stay safe.